I'm Kelly Cobble from the Quincy Art Association, and I am currently the interim president. For the month of May, the Art Association hosts an art exhibit down at the Thomas Crane Library, and it runs really through the month of May from the beginning to the end. And we will be having a reception on Saturday, May 12th from 1 to 3, where we celebrate the artists that have won awards, as well as just open it up to a time where the public can meet some of the artists that are on exhibit. We have been exhibiting at the Thomas Crane for well over 25 years. It's something that started because we wanted to have the Art Association incorporated more into the community. And the library was our perfect venue. We appreciate all the community service that the library does. The Art Association's mission is really to bring the visual arts into the community of Quincy as well as the South Shore. And we do have many artists from all over the South Shore that are our members. And membership, we provide free demonstrations, so we want it to be a continuing education opportunity. And we have people that will demonstrate their techniques of using mosaic or watercolor painting. We've had Chinese painting techniques. And then we have several exhibits that we host or either collaborate on throughout the year. So this is our second exhibit that we are participating in. We had a pop-up gallery in January, and now we have our Spring Into Art show at the library. And then in August, we collaborate with five or six other art associations from the South Shore on the Arts Affair, which is held at Marina Bay. And then our big event is the Arts Fest, where we partner with the city of Quincy, and we have arts and crafts, as well as a very large art show and all kinds of fun activities for family members, as well as wonderful music. And the symphony orchestra the Quincy Symphony gives a free concert on the Saturday evening of that weekend. So that's in September. We really are trying to get the mission of sharing artwork in the community. So we're always looking for opportunities to have artists show their works, whether they be in restaurants or in some of the new development that's happening around Quincy. We're hoping that we can get artists into lobbies, or sometimes at the high school we'll coordinate with the art teachers, and we'll have our artists in with the public school artists, or work with the art teachers so that we can showcase their talents. The Quincy Art Association has grown over the years. We started with just a very small pool of volunteers that were all artists and needed a community place to come and to be able to create. And from that, we have really grown into advocating for more cultural resources in the city and on the South Shore. So it's something that we take very seriously, and we do try to make ourselves available for the city of Quincy. So if they need cultural or artists or a different perspective on their development, we always try to be at the front row, row of that. We love having the opportunity to show at the library because of the diverse community that it serves. We love how art speaks to that diverse community. So we're thrilled that people will have an opportunity to spend as little or as much time with the art as possible. And it just gives them a reminder that the Art Association is a vibrant and a wonderful part of our community. It's open to everybody. Our demonstrations and our free learning opportunities are open to anybody to come by when they see them advertised. The Quincy Art Association firmly believes in the classes that we offer, and we do start them at very young. We've been able to offer clay classes. We have a wheel and a whole kiln that can take the process from beginning to end. And we also have classes in painting, in drawing, and sometimes in mixed media. And we have very caring and talented art teachers that really embrace their enthusiasm and their talents to work with the children. And we do firmly believe that if children are exposed to art at a young age, that it will make them more intelligent, probably problem solvers. You know, it gets them out into the community and interacting and more social, but also give them a sense of value and their own personal experience to be able to work with the art objects. So art and culture is something that we take serious, and we love taking it from age 5 all the way up to 95 if they can still come in and work with their hands. Quincy Art Association does have a website, which is quincyartma.org, and we have our calendar of events as well as our classes and some information about the history of the Art Association. It's been in existence for well over 50 years. And we also have a Facebook page that we keep up to date, as well as just recently going to Eventbrite so that people can purchase the classes or register online. Just please come down to the Thomas Crane Library and see two institutions that have been working together for a long time. And please spread our joy and spring into art. It's finally, springtime is finally on its way, and hopefully our artists will be reflecting that in the artwork that you'll see.